I can hear the giggle.
I'm having a snippet of myself in the background. Hello, everyone.
Good morning.
Then we were chatting away, and then I looked at the clock and thought, oh, it's 10:30, we've got to go live, and we had to finish off what we were talking about.
Sorry, yeah, we did get a bit carried away, didn't we?
And then I started playing around with some little buttons. Do you know we've got a new one?
Oh, have we? What have we got?
Oh, that's if it shows up. Hang on. Can you see it?
One day.
One day of quarantine. This is what's called a widget in Studio 2 of B.Live platform for streaming. So that's
technology to play with.
Yeah, and here's another. I just noticed it. And look at that. There's a thermometer. And that's actually what your temperature is.
Oh, really?
That's what it's supposed to be indicating. Now, I looked at this and I thought, oh, my goodness, who's got more time than it's worth, really? I mean, what would you really need to – oh, hang on, how do I get rid of it?
Seriously, that can't be my temperature.
I don't know. You'll
have to – how can they do that?
36.6. I have no idea. No idea.
I haven't stuck my tongue out yet for it.
Oh, whoops, there's the two widgets. What corners are they in?
Those. Oh, that way.
One's that, no, that way, so it's that way and that way.
Yeah, I've got the temperature on my bottom. Oh, God, that way, that corner. And then the other thing is up in that corner, the one day.
Oh, trying to show my – oh, why's that? Whoops, wrong one. I was hitting the wrong button there. Here's me playing with the buttons. Look at that. Yeah, look, as I was going through the community last night, the BeLivers community, I did notice it said something about widgets, and I thought, oh, yeah, it'll be a while before we in Australia get it. Well, did it this morning. There's the widget thing. Oh. I played with it then because I needed to get my daily one up and running too. All these things. It's fun. I dare say with a lot of people being in that mode of I've forgotten the term. What is it? Isolation?
Yes.
They're still using that social distancing and the rest when it's actually physical. And I just noticed I better put my ear. I don't think I'm echoing anywhere, am I?
No.
I'll put these in and make sure that I'm not. You know, it's various things that we actually need to. And I've got to change my setting now just to make sure. Oh, gosh. Does that mean I have to refresh my screen?
I'm not too sure. I can still hear you.
You can still hear me. I can't hear through these. Oh, look, I'll just leave it. Am I echoing now, though?
No, not that I'm noticing. Put it that way.
Okay. Now, if there's someone who is in the MyTimeTV.live platform page, can you please comment? Because comments aren't coming up in the background at the moment. I can probably say comment here. In that end of it, because I haven't checked the Facebook page yet. The comment's coming.
That's your comment.
That's my comment.
Let me jump over to my time and see if there's comments in there.
Oh, goody, goody. One just popped up. Good.
Oh, beautiful. Excellent. There we go. Morning. Hey, honey.
Will my grandparents be okay with all this going on? As my pup has a lot of health issues and my nan's far too social. Oh, goodness, that's sad when you've got to cut it back too.
It is. It's really hard.
Yeah. I have got an echo somewhere.
Oh, have you?
Or is that noise? Have you got a radio in the background or TV or something
going? That's probably my husband.
Oh, that's all right then.
Now on the other end of the house.
That's fine. I don't care. We live in our homes at the moment. We work from our homes, so that's what it is.
And I forgot to remind you Mama's going live because usually he'll turn it down.
Well, when Tony said that he was going to go down to the shop, he's got to get a few things for his boat and that when we head up there tomorrow. I was doing something else because I'm still unpacking boxes, right? My goal is one or two boxes per day until it's all done. I've managed most of it and I'm sort of sitting here, you know, here's a bundle of things that I've got to sort of sort through. Do I want to keep and the rest out of one box? and I'm busy doing that. And I thought, oh, yeah, okay, not thinking too much of it. And then I sort of was doing something else, and then I looked up and I thought, oh, shit, it's 20 past 10. I still hadn't done the cross-posting. I still hadn't done other stuff. Oh, okay. Better, you know, head down, tail up and get into it.
Yeah. It gets like that, though, doesn't it?
Yeah, it does. The focus was where it was.
Yeah.
And with that in mind, just a reminder for anyone that's on the other cross-posted pages, which is Live Video Hub and my page of Ros Boundy and Leanne Winston Psychic Medium page, all of those cross-posted pages, if you are commenting in there, I can't see them. So you need to make sure you're clicking on the mytimetv.live link. It's supposed to have cross-posted with what I did this morning. There's a link in the top that has the last three digits. You know, it's a number at the end of my time, video number, et cetera. Click on that. And we've got Mary Ann here. Good morning.
Morning, honey. Hope you're well.
I did already put that there. So there's still only two comments, which is highly unusual for what we get in our feed. So very good. Happening or you're on the wrong page, please come over to mytimetv.live, okay? And are you checking those back pages?
Yeah, I'm just having a look, sorry.
Hey, no, that's all right.
I'm concentrating on what I was doing.
What are you saying? Anything, can you not be hearing?
I'm hearing you. So it's just a bit delayed. I'm thinking, what's going on here?
Look. I think it was in those early days of being married, and this was going back probably 40 years ago, right?
That's a few years ago.
That's a long time ago, yes. But it was in those early days I realised for some people you actually have to be standing in front of them to actually get their attention. And you'd think that, you know, early years of marriage you'd have that attentiveness there 24/7. Nah, when it was cricket season and there was cricket on the TV, I even pranced past butt naked one time because I wanted to get the attention. And all he did at that point was just look around to watch the TV. yeah, look, it really does. It really is where our attention is, like that energy is flowing to what our attention is focused on, even to the point of a blindness, a blind spot. And it can be right in front of you, you know, there you go. You've got that spot to focus on and you still miss it.
That's it, exactly.
It is funny. In again, right. So let us know where you're from. Do a hashtag in the city or, you know, country, whatever, just so we can know. It's lovely to see how far and wide we are actually transmitting is the word, but it's not really what we're doing. We're on the internet. The internet itself does that, doesn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's it, I think.
So it's not like the radio and the TV days, although we are called mytimetv.live. Mm. And we are live, so it's nice to see those comments scrolling. I like that.
Yeah, great. Yeah. I gave up looking because we're live. Obviously, the computer slows down. So when you said they're coming in, I'm like, close it.
Well, there is a few here.
Yeah.
Just the occasional reminder: if you're on the other pages, make sure you're on mytimetv.live. Do let others know that we're here live, and to direct them to the mytimetv.live. Then I'll see the comments in the background.
Yeah. So did everybody have a lovely Easter? I can't believe Easter's been and gone already.
Yeah, and that's just what I was going to ask you. How did your Easter go?
It was nice. So it wasn't the same not being able to do the whole family thing and stuff like that, but we went for a drive a couple of days. I've got a daughter on an L plate, so we just get in the car, go for a drive, let her get some experience up in some of our hours because we've been a bit sort of busy leading up to this sort of period where she hasn't been so overly keen to drive, but now all of a sudden she is. And so we just went for a drive, enjoyed the sunshine, turned around, didn't even have to stop, coming home sort of thing. So it was lovely. So
that's good. Yeah,
because we work from home and like hubby's not working at the moment because of his work being closed down and whatnot. Kids aren't at school. It's kind of felt like the walls are starting to close in. So to me, to get outside and even just be in the car and go for a drive like that is quite relaxing in that sense. So you know what? I think we all at some stage through this quarantine need to do something that otherwise we're just going to be climbing the walls. Sort of thing. So I think
that's part of, you know, they're mentioning what don't do anything unless it's essential. Well, I think at times there are those moments where you need to do something different just for the mental health, and yeah, it's essential.
Well, mental health is essential, isn't it? So
yeah. Oh, look, going up to the top tomorrow, and Tony had sort of mentioned, he doesn't want to be booked for it. He's not sure if he should. And I said, look, hang on, your address is there. It's essential to go and keep going home on your house. It's fine, you know.
That's it.
It's part of what is essential, you know.
Exactly. And it's not like you're going up there to a big group of people or anything like that. Oh. It's two people in one house with two dogs that's moving into a, you know, spending some time at the partner's house. So.
Yeah, it's just spending time there for that. What's an essential appointment up the other end as well, and you know, it is stuff that's going to be part of what's allowed. And in that time, we'll be isolating ourselves anyway.
Yeah.
We always do anyway, because we are little hermits. And I love that.
I was just looking at my hair, and I'm thinking I need a haircut and another colour, and I think that might be essential very soon.
Well, I think some hairdressers are still working, so, you know.
Yeah, I think they can do 30-minute appointments or something, or that may have even changed, so.
I really don't know. And good morning, Debbie. How are you?
Good morning, honey.
We've got a few here now, so I might as well. And there's some more wanting cards and stuff, so we will get through that. So, hi, Emma and Tanya. I hope you all have had wonderful Easter yourselves. Mm. Whoops, that one went off quick. Angel.
I think it's supposed to be.
Yeah, Angel. And Tanya, hi to you. Oh, I said that already because you. we've got Regina and doing.
Good morning, everyone.
Yeah, is it working now? Oh, yeah, look, it looks like it probably is. And then we've got Diana and Shannon. I'm just going to flip through these and we'll go back as we need to, because I just heard you've got some cards come out, haven't you?
Yeah, I drew me to the cards. I thought, let's play with the cards too.
Debbie and Natalia.
Good morning, everyone.
Oh, I like that icon. Oh, lovely photo of you. Wodonga. Now, Victoria.
Hello. I have a friend over that way.
Yeah. Now, lots of us were on the wrong page. Yeah, your page come up, but the My Time, not for a while. That's interesting.
And so they might be doing changes again in their algorithms.
Look, I have actually had a bit of chasing around trying to get my link into the cross-posted stuff, because I did have someone querying it was so hard to find a link to get back to the original page, like the source page, like this one is, it's My Time Today, whereas in the mornings it's my Ros Boundy page, right? And I've had to sort of work out and nut out, and I put it in the description when I cross post, put it in that description there too, and it should go with the cross post to the it's been a challenge.
It's called technology, and I think the whole system is just on overload at the moment. So,
New Zealand, which I hadn't realised before. Yeah. Kellyanne Launceston. Wow. Oh, I like
beautiful.
It. There. Does that
It does feel like stickers.
Take me to notice the chocolate.
You know what? It took me all Easter weekend to actually have a piece of chocolate last night, and that was about 11:30. And it was that one that pops in your mouth. It's like, oh, I like this.
Oh, no, I haven't tried that. What I did, we only went up to the shop because we are doing only minimal shopping as we need it. So I went up Thursday night to get the few essentials, and I thought we would get one, you know, the biggish Easter egg each. I'd get us one each of those. There wasn't any. That also.
I did that Saturday.
Cream filled little Easter eggs. So, yeah, over the last few days, but not clean the whole part in one hit, which I would have done as a kid. Ontario, Canada. Hi, Joanne.
Beautiful.
Yeah, more questions coming up now. Yeah, is there any guidance for me? Good morning. Oh, Dev Mum.
Hey, Mum. Hope you're well this morning.
Thank you, apart from no extra family. Yeah, look, it's certainly been a lot different this year. And I dare say with your daughter having her practice driving, it would have been a fairly clear drive with the number of cars not being on the road like they normally are through Easter, wouldn't it?
Yeah, it was. The weekend, like over the weekend, it was pretty dead. The only afternoon, when did we go out? Sunday afternoon, coming home, because we actually went. One day we went to Adelaide, the other day we went to Murray Bridge, and Sunday coming home there was a bit of traffic on the freeway down through the hills, but besides that it was pretty dead. Lots of trucks last night coming home because she's got to do night hours as well, so we came back in the park, so yeah. Lots of trucks. Trucks are going much more than the 100 Ks, believe me.
It's a shame they do. I mean, having been an owner of a business that did the heavy trucks, as in, tandem tippers and all the rest, yes, it's not worth the fine you get if you do get caught.
Oh, well, there was one company that had three trucks travelling together and she's going up a slight hill doing her 100 Ks and they just flew past us, the whole three of them. And I'm thinking they've got to be doing over their 110 going uphill.
Yeah. Well, they wouldn't have been loaded. They're going back home to get another load of this, so if that was the case.
Yeah.
They couldn't be at that rate if they're loaded. But anyway. Anyway. Yeah. So
it's life.
Yeah. Now, we will get on to cards now. Because what I thought I'd choose, and this is where I'm going to play with some buttons again. I know you people will indulge me because I love you and you love me. I'm just going to try undoing that one and probably solo one.
Oh, we've got all chocolate cards.
What I'm going to do is the chocolate cards, and I've got the psychic tarot if that's where I feel led to, and I thought, well, that's what I'm going to do this morning.
So I think chocolate cards are perfect for this time of year.
I turned off the video at the same time as turn off the solo. Not a good cookbook. So who have we got first? We've got Jamie Lee.
It's
your first time here. Oh, that's wonderful.
Beautiful. Welcome, honey.
All those top comments are already rolled off.
They took a while to come through, and then when they do, they take off. Can I pull a card for Jamie Lee? Is that all right?
Can you pull a card for her? Because I did say it's probably there somewhere further down.
Yeah. So, honey, I've got the Lenormand deck out. So, Jamie Lee, I want to say allow that inner child to come out and play at the moment. And I get the feeling there's a lot of exciting energy building within. Changes are coming, and it's about enjoying yourself and having fun while doing it. All right. So, you're a beautiful soul. I love your energy. So, all the best.
Yes, all the best with that one. I know we read this one out as the first. I think this one might have been the top one after all.
Kellyanne was.
Who knows? I'm actually feeling, look, your grandparents will be okay. They are wise people, even if it seems to you that they may be a little frivolous. They're making their own choices around what risk they want to take with the coronavirus and being present. I feel, though, that you're not seeing all of the picture and they are actually being more careful than you've seen. So they'll be okay.
Yeah. I think they're both as stubborn as each other as well, so good luck trying to change them.
Yeah.
Ros, I'm on solo, honey.
Oh, you are too. Oops. That's me in play mode. It's just the energy around me. Look, this morning's reading, I just felt an excitement through the whole thing. And I don't know why, because if I was looking at the cards that in the spread that I'd had, it would have seemed a bit, you know, for the average, I suppose, they would have seen those cards going by the guidebook type stuff and sort of thought, oh, that's a bit negative. Oh, that's a bit heavy. I didn't feel that at all. I felt the light, brightness, positivity. The sun was right in the middle. That was the outcome. Beautiful energy around, and I've felt light and bright since.
Just a reminder, if anybody would like information on our up-and-coming expo on the online expo on the 3rd of May, put the number 8 in the comments below so you go into our, what is it called, our bot system that will keep you updated on what's going on.
Yep, yeah, the chat bot will trigger and you'll get some updates.
Yes, I see Adair put the 8 there as a reminder to let us know she's hooked it up. So.
Oh, that's right down the. See, I haven't gotten down the bottom.
It caught my eye. So I thought,
there it is. Coming up. Yes. All you have to do is type the digit 8. Remember, it's the infinity as well. that's what I like to see too when it's the, the snake in the card, the Lenormand deck. Because it's so close to being the 8, all possibilities. Taylor's put here, morning ladies, I'm moving back to my mum's this week. Just wondering if you can see me getting my own rental. I'm seeing a no on that one personally. That's what energy I'm getting around that at the moment.
I think being at home with mum's a good thing at the moment.
Yeah, yeah. It won't be in the immediate future is what I'm saying. It's just definitely was a no on that one. So we said good morning to now, did we do one for Emma? No, not yet. I just scrolled past and that was one, or a card. I'm going to get the chocolate ones out for that one. And I have no idea whether I'll just poke it up in front of me. It might be easier than using the buttons that I'm getting all mucked up and around the place, aren't I? So this card is for Emma, and I like to shuffle 3 times, so that's what you're hearing. What I've got in that one is Armin. Now, do you know what? I do like to do them like this. I'll just see how it works. Get rid of some boxes. Oh, there's the box. I'll just get the – see how it works. And solo that. So that's the box that this card deck is from. And here you've got Armin. Can we see it well enough? No.
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 Not focusing.
No, and you know why? It's because the light is just too high from the window. So what I'll do is I'll solo me and hold it up. And hopefully if I get it right, no, wrong way. There we have Armin in front of that, and it's still not.
Honestly, your camera seems blurry to me, but.
Well, it's looking blurry to me too.
Yeah.
That's a real bummer. Let me see if this one will. Oh, I've got to put the camera on. Does it if I hold? Oh, there.
It's a little bit better. Yeah, it's better.
I've just got to hold it up. So Armin is around achievements. So there's the message for you from Spirit today. So it's actually putting focus around your achievements. And if you can read that, But what I'll do is unsolo, hide that, and just so it speaks of high expectations, grand ideals, and elevated priorities. So it signifies a workaholic and overachiever. So don't be too overachieving. Don't be working too much into it. Just be mindful of your goals and how you plan to achieve them. So that's what that one's about. So hopefully that's meaningful to you there, Emma, as we have that card for you. And Angel, we've got her. We haven't done a reading. I just said hello first. That wasn't it.
Yeah. Yep, that's right. So morning, Angel. I think there's a little bit of frustrating stuck energy around you, honey, so I do get the reference to it's important to acknowledge that at the moment. I want to say acknowledge it, let it go, because it's not serving a purpose in your life at the moment. Things are going to come back into balance soon, and I get the reference to that you will start to see that energy change in a positive way shortly. Okay?
Yeah, good.
Just send me a big hug and wishing you well.
Yeah, thank you, Angel, for that. And as of my turn, rather than fiddling around with the I was going to do that again, wasn't I? Hang on, I will fiddle around with the camera.
Decisions.
And hold it up like this. Here you've got, Tanya, the Turkish Delight, and that's about adventure. And if I can read it from there, since I'm solo, your heightened sense of curiosity will find you in all kinds of situations, places, and mixing with ethnic or multicultural friends. Laughter and richness of life is what you're seeking right now. So, I'm going to change my mind and do this differently. Because, and I'm going to, I have.
Yum, Turkish delight.
Looking at that, it says, prepare for foreign travel and fantasy. Your mind seeks new sources of stimulation as your journey takes you to depths of your soul you never knew existed. Wow. There is actually affirmations at the bottom of these.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
I had a pack and I gave them away to somebody.
Oh, this is interesting. I'm going to, instead of solo, let's just hide that. And then we go like that. Which way round's that? Wrong way round. That way we can see your gorgeous face too. do people like that aspect of how I'm showing it? I'd like to know the third way.
That way we can see the cards and you can read it at the same time.
Which is why I decided to do this. I can read it quite easily whilst you're looking at the gorgeous picture. The affirmation at the bottom says, I open my heart to new adventures and with an open mind I seek new experiences. So how's that, Tanya? I reckon, going to do it that way.
I love it.
So I'm going to ditch the I won't ditch it. I'll actually take the second camera out of it for now and just concentrate on doing it this way because it looks like it's easier to do. Now, let's go back to, now that did move off the screen. Next one in line that I can see.
Hey, gorgeous. Hi, ladies. Hubby got a new job, which is a blessing with so many that have lost a job. Trying to get a house and hubby's spending dollars at motel. Do you see us getting a house soon? Many thank you. Thanks. You have 39 watches. Thank you, honey. I get the number 7 around that, so I feel like I'm probably more around the 7th of the month, 7 weeks' time, or July with that side of it. So I do see a house coming soon, but probably not quite as quickly as you would like it to. All right. So my feeling is that there's going to be a lot of stuff out there available when the timing is right. Okay.
Yeah. I think there's a lot. Oh, they have. Yeah. Now the messages are scrolling off the screen. I wonder if they'll come back. Diana's is the next one on the top that I can see. But we all.
They're on the page.
Because, oh, wow. They really are chuffing off the top of the screen like it wouldn't be. So this next one.
Yeah, I think it's Facebook.
Yeah. It is. This next card that I did for someone else that was on the screen earlier, it's actually going to be for you, Joanne. So your husband would like to know if he's going to retire soon and if yes, will he be financially okay or struggle? So what I got for you in this one, and I'll do what I did before, which goes that way. Oh, but the comment's right in front of your face.
Hang on. I could go like this. Hang on.
What we've got is milkshake. It says open your heart. So it's time to shake things up a bit. In general, things are going well, but you may feel trapped in monotony at this time, especially in this time of restrictions. Remember, you are loved, cared for, and content as you search internally to identify what little something needs to be defined. So now is the time to remember you are one with the universe. Meditate and share all the positive energy you can muster. And the world all around will seem a much better place when you allow yourself to open your heart a little more. I bring you joy. This is the affirmation. I bring my own joy into my life and I share that joy with everyone I meet. So for me, that's indicating what you need to be doing. got your back. Choose the positive. It is opening up the heart and bringing the positive thoughts only into your mindset rather than even doubting or figuring that what you're moving into is going to be a struggle. You've got abundance around you and you've got love within and around you. So focus on that. So this is the next one for you.
I couldn't help myself. Good morning, Scott.
Well, what we do.
Oh, goodness. I'm actually torn with that energy, honey. I think there's some work that both of you need to do on yourselves before anything can change. And I don't feel like it's something that you've got to rush into trying to reconcile the relationship as much as your heart is broken at the moment. I get you need to go back within. This is your time to focus on you. And I get the feeling your partner will do the same thing as well. So I get there is hope, but the timing isn't there at the moment, okay? All right, so sending you a big healing hug as well, because I can feel your sadness, your pain.
Okay. I was feeling a bit that way as well too. So thank you for your question. Now I've got one for Diane.
Hey, Diane.
And I like that. Oh, whoop, wrong way around. I can't be hidden as I'm doing it.
There you go.
Oh, card. Oh, I wish we had that little band in the comments. So I'm just going to drop the comments. So here's relationship. It's sprinkles. And I'm trying to get it to focus, but what's at the bottom is party animal. And this card signifies a time of festivity and merrymaking. In these restrictions, you're going to have a party by yourself. people are openly enjoying happy, vibrant, enthusiastic energy, which is all around you at this time. So hit the dance floor, plan a school reunion or a party, or organise a fundraiser. Your energy is captivating and contagious, so being the centre of attention will serve you well. It's what your soul needs right now, so get into that planning. And the affirmation is, my inner child wants to play and I listen to its needs and honour them. So in the relationship aspect, what I'm feeling is that, especially at this particular point in time, it's more around that inner work that we need to be doing right now and the relationship with self. So have some fun with that. And, yes, once this is all passed, it's the time now to plan for things that are going to be once all this is passed. So have some fun with some planning and doing something really fun once you've got that sorted, and include what you want in a relationship with that other that's going to be part of that planning.
Yeah. So. And you know what, the saying, what is it, when you're given lemons, make lemonade. I really do feel it is about at the moment focusing on us, because when this, I keep calling it the dust, when the dust settles, life isn't going to be the same as we know it. It's going to be actually much better than what we not remember it to be. So there's going to be a lot more opportunities, a lot more loving light out there. Things are going to change in a big way. So as much as, you know, you've got the government and everybody looking at all this financial burden and stuff that has been, or stress that has been put on, you know, every country and stuff like that, we make the most out of it. If we choose to sit in that negative energy, that's what we're going to draw into our lives. But I know for myself, my mind is constantly going, how can I recreate myself into bringing my work online and connecting with people? To me, it's opening, it's a positive, it's opening up and pushing me to connect with people worldwide, not just those that want to come and see me personally or I can travel to locally sort of thing or within the state. So let's take this as a positive and be the best version of us that we can recreate ourselves into being. So, and it's very much about nurturing us at the moment too. So, you know, let's go back within and build from there. Yeah. What do you think, Ros?
Well, I definitely think it's the timing now, while we've got the space and the time forced by what's happening. It's certainly time. Oh, that's where that's coming from.
It wasn't me.
No, bees picked up the iPad sound as a notification came through. And I had to go down under my desk because you see this little pile of cards?
Yeah.
To shuffle, as small as they are, and they fit in the palm of the hand real nicely, but because it's such a fat pile, I lost half of them.
Your fingers weren't quite long enough?
And then I realised I should have done the mute the video instead of left that going, but at least it did drop me to small.
Oh, God.
Now, we've got Rebecca next, haven't we? So I'm just quickly shuffling the cards over the desk this time, not just back from the desk. So in case they fall apart. Oh, yum. I do like hazelnuts. Here we've got the card for you, and it's hazelnuts. And that's about sophistication. So I've got to focus my eyes on this. The print's getting smaller and smaller. It's time to start enjoying life. Spoil yourself a little. So expose yourself to the finer things that life has to offer. Take a metaphorical journey back to the golden olden days where life offered an air of class, style, and sophistication. So indulge yourself by taking the day off to watch an old romantic movie, hire a vintage car, or temporarily dip your toe into the decadent world of self-indulgent obsession. Lovely. You've worked hard for your success, and now's the time to enjoy the fruits of your labor. And the affirmation, I deserve the fruits of my labor. So
nice.
Wonderful. Lovely. Nut. Oh, I just, well, you know, you team that with chocolate, you can get Nutella. Oh, lovely. chocolate bar.
Here I have been thinking I should go on a diet and go walking. Well, I've been improving my eating, but.
Oh, thanks, Ross. Oh, sorry, I better bring up full size too.
I like being shrinked. We're having too much fun.
That's a good way to do it. It's easier than going walking.
I think nearly every day for a week I've said to my husband, we should go for a walk, but he takes Tara she goes for a ride around. We've got a pond not far from us, so she rides a bike around there because she doesn't want to walk. He walks the dog. Yeah. And I'm either wrapped up in work, or like Sunday I went to bed with a bit of a headache because he got a bit drunk and
yep.
She'd had a couple of drinks as well. So yeah. They ran out of cat food, so they went over to the servo of all places to get out with the walk for the dog.
Yeah.
Tara came home, she said, Mum, I just had to keep apologising to the attendee there because he was wanting to bring the dog in the shop. And she's going, but you want cat food, but you've got a dog. I think it was one of those conversations you needed to be there for, but I can just imagine that. My husband talks a lot of crap when he's drunk. Doesn't get drunk very often.
I'd have to say, yeah, it's been a long time since I've been that way.
Yeah. Quite a while since I did.
I can certainly remember some instances over my youth that were very noteworthy, but I'm not going to share here. all perfect, lovely, cool morning. Oh,
lovely. We've got your heat coming. Over here we're getting up to 34, 35 degrees this week.
Oh, so that's why it's sunshiny and lovely.
Yeah, it's supposed to be like 30 or 32 today or something here in Adelaide.
Well, I better take the dogs for a walk before it gets too hot. Thank you for that, Michelle. I'm going to – is it your turn or my turn?
She didn't think it's fine.
Anything, but I thought, you know, she's not
– I love her energy, and I've got one that's run away.
You're quite right. It's not the same as FaceTiming your family, and I just remembered I didn't FaceTime my family. Oops.
Oh, no. We can extend Easter out. Beautiful. Honey, with this, I'm actually drawn to everything becoming more centred with that. I get there's a lot of wisdom in you, but it is about bringing the focus back into the centre, which is you. And I get the reference then that there's a lot of growth that is going to come from that. Okay, I get there's been a lot of changes around you, but now is the time that this is all going to start settling down and the growth will come within. Go within for the wisdom, because I get there is that wisdom. You just know what to say, when to say it. All right? So wishing you all the best with that. What are you giggling at, Ros? What did you do? There's something around the corner.
But the thing is... Here's where that opposites is really a dumb thing unless you look. With me thinking going that way, I was going to be able to sneak a slurp of my coffee. And I was
looking around the corner of the comments.
I'd gone the wrong way. Oh, dear, sorry about that.
If you'd stayed straight up with the comment, we'd have hidden that.
That's what I thought I was doing. I was going the wrong way.
Oh my god.
Very sorry about that.
Who needs to have a party when you just get online and have fun?
Oh,
never a dumb moment with us, is there?
No, the things that one does. And here, I mean, I have chosen the chocolate cards to go with today. I've got, and you were, yeah, you've done that one. And what I was going next to was Michelle's. And I'm sort of thinking, well, I'll shuffle those. No, I'm over this way. I'll just sneak that. No, the comment thing hides my face a long way. But that's all right. So, Michelle, here's your card, and it is out of the chocolate deck because that's my favourite for the day today. Well, actually, for this session, I really like the Lenormand. And I've got to pick the right button. Yes, sir. So now, Leanne, if you'd like a drink, you can choose to have one now.
Thank you.
Move the right way. dark chocolate, young shadow self. So you're saying you're feeling uneasy due to the work cutbacks. You're not working due to cutbacks. See, that really is where you need to actually read the question properly. Mm. I've done that now. So you aren't working. You've had your cutback happen to you. Here is the card, dark chocolate. It's about the shadow self. So it's time to embrace your shadow self. Illuminate the darker side of your nature by allowing some light to flow in. It's time to free yourself from past bitterness, hurt, and resentment so you can make sense of the chaos. Surrender the pain and heal. So it's actually also asking you to question your belief systems. What is holding you back? Why are you here? Why did you create your current situation? Is it now time to be more personally accountable? So here's the affirmation as well. I only hold positive thoughts. My actions are of pure intent. So I think that also goes back to that feature that we have as human beings of looking at the negative first at times and having the worry and allowing the fear to take hold. Grab that positive and move forward with that. Spend the time that you're not working at the moment to create different ideas of those positive things that you'd like to see in your life, that you'd like to move toward, and ways and steps that you can actually use to actually have that happen instead of wondering, oh, when am I going to get back to work? Create something new that really is that positive for yourself and move it forward. As Leanne had said earlier, and I totally agree, things aren't going to be the same as they were when we move past and through this virus issue. It's temporary. Things will change, and make it that positive path you want.
Yeah.
Okay.
Those chocolate cards have got me thinking. Next time I decide I want to create a deck of cards, I should do a wine deck. Go with the chocolates. Something different,
wouldn't it? And then have it match with the right chocolate card. Yeah, exactly. Create your own chocolate card. Oh,
yeah.
It's got some thoughts. See, there's some possibilities. Michelle, are you an artist? Oh, that's responding to, yes, us going up to the shack. Yes, we do pay our rates. We're entitled to do what. It is a necessary thing, doing that. Oh, Sam, you're asking, and it's your turn.
Beautiful. Because it's a general one, I'm going to just pull you a card, and it jumped out already. So welcome from Rockhampton. All right. So, honey, I get look at those bigger things. The structure is in front of you and it's well built. You've worked hard for it. And I get the reference to it is building up still. There's a lot of, I'm also drawn to the sunlight that is coming through the back of the card here. So whether you've been feeling that little bit of restricted, but sort of feel closed in, I do get there's a lot of positive energy starting to work its way through. So I do get the shift is coming. Focus on home at the moment, building that structure in the way that you want it. Like I said, a lot of the hard work is done behind you, but look at the positives that are coming with it as well, okay? And 9, 10, new beginnings, all right? So when you break the 19 down, there's a 1, which is new beginnings, okay? So wishing you all the best.
Great stuff to be starting on something new, isn't it?
Definitely. Yeah.
I missed one. There was one there. Oh, no, that was it. Sorry. It was the hello from Tony because I don't think I'd got down this.
Gorgeous lady. Happy Easter to you. Hope Easter Bunny found you.
Yeah. Yeah, exactly. And this is the one that I went and got for the next person, which happens to be Jasmine. And I thought, oh, nice card. Oh, wrong one. Wedding. So there's family happenings around a wedding. Now, hopefully that's going to be planned for after all these restrictions are lifted, or so it's a happy family life surrounded. So whether you're partnered or single, this card refers to parents, siblings, children, friendships. You're emotionally and spiritually fulfilled and love abounds. So live in the moment and seize the day, which is that Latin carpe diem. Make sure you share the good energy you're radiating with those around you. Your personality is infectious at the moment, as well as like a corona. Spread it like that. And you are helping people who are feeling down without even realizing you're doing so. So the affirmation around that, I've got to hold it up a bit higher, don't I? Is I enjoy a happy family life. I'm blessed with good family and friends, and I share my love around. So wonderful blessing for you in getting that card. So thank you for asking for a card. Now we've got Nita, who's your turn.
Hey, Lenny. All right. Oh, I want to say stop and breathe at the moment, honey. I just feel like there's a little bit of nervous energy around you. Okay, I've got two cards that came up. The first one is you're heading in the right direction. I want to say have fun doing it, what you're doing, because there's new beginnings coming in the one with that side of it, but the focus is on you. All right, so go back within. Look at what it is your heart desires, what it is that you want on that soul level, and allow that energy to come in because it's heading in the right direction. Okay, so I want to say, like I said before to Michelle, I think it was, the hard work's behind you. Now it's about putting you first. You've got such a big heart. You need to start nurturing you rather than looking after everybody else. Mm. All right, so wishing you all the best.
So thank you, Nita. And this one, I noticed it is the next one in line from what I've got at my end. So it's Jamie Lee. A card would be amazing also.
I did one for her before.
Yeah, I thought so. And I just, I thought, well, the next one's the next one in line, and it was the sprinkles. So even though you've asked for a second one, it's fine. It's the party animal. Mm. So I've already explained that one. So that was a real quickie for you. Okay. An extra. Now, how would you pronounce that? Charlia? Hello. I'm just cutting the deck, and you've got the next one in the deck. So this is the card that I've got, and you might do one so that Charlie is going to be lucky and have two cards. So, what I've got there is the fudge, and I'll do it this way. So it's moving forward. So it's time to leave something behind that no longer serves you. So change may lead to sadness, but separation can lead to happiness. The promise of change holds your best interest at heart. So know and trust that new and good times are ahead. Good things are waiting for you. Trust your gut feelings at this time. So as you prepare to leave a relationship that isn't working, a job that no longer feeds your soul, or a living arrangement that no longer provides, trust that something better is coming your way. And the affirmation for this one is, I'll move forward with no regrets. I leave my past behind and walk into a brighter future. That sounds pretty good to me.
And while you're doing that, it's going to bring balance. So I get the reference to you can bring in balance with that change in all directions of your life, honey. All right? So that feels great. Wonderful.
Yeah.
Focus on the study books too. So I get the study books being put in front of you.
And that'll bring some good change. Yeah.
Yeah.
And here is Jamie saying, I remember seeing Murray on a drive from Perth to Adelaide.
That's a long drive.
I'm planning on doing that later this year. I've got a son in Perth, or just north of Perth anyway. Now, good morning. Oh, here now, that's a reminder. Those who are on other pages that are cross-posted, Leanne Winston, Psychic Medium, Ros Boundy's page, Live in 5, be clicking on that link that says mytimetv.live. Okay, yep. Reminder for that one. Okay, and we're here now. Hello, ladies. Hope you're staying safe.
Hey, honey. Yeah, I hope you are too.
And Shannon.
Beautiful.
You have a card ready.
Can I have a card, please? Beautiful, yes. All right. Oh, honey, I get you're quite intuitive yourself as well. So I want to say Focus on that intuition, and also be careful of those energies around you, because I do feel there is somebody that is trying to hold you back at the moment. So I want to say you feel that push to move forward and do what it is that your heart desires, what your soul desires. But I get feeling of being, you've got people around you, or a person, I get a female energy with that, that is ready to strike at any time. But I get it's jealousy. So to me, it's what you do in your life is sort of what she is lacking in hers, and she's jealous of that, but she doesn't want to help herself to make change. All right, you've worked hard for what you've got. You're heading in the right direction. Just keep shining that beautiful light. Okay?
So thank you for that, Jo. And, Jamie Lee, you just mentioned there, lovely, yes, you've realised, yes, you've had a card pulled, and now too, you had trouble with your video. Now, that's just a reminder to let everyone know, with every live stream that you get on Facebook, I'm assuming it's every one of them, you do have the option to watch the replay, because they stay in Facebook until they're deleted, as far as I understand. Is that correct, Leanne?
Yeah, they're there forever. If you can scroll back far enough, you'll find it in 10 years' time.
I'm going to have a few because I do a daily live.
I was just thinking that. I don't even scroll through my page as well if there's 3-4 posts a day.
Absolutely. So, yeah, you'll be able to go back and find for yourself the spot that was there. I don't go back and do the time stamps or anything. I had vision of doing that, but it's just not the time to do that. If you feel that you need to re-watch these videos, do so. There's always going to be good information anyway, with the way the cards pull or the descriptions of readings that Leanne or I or anyone else should watch, actually, for that matter.
Or you just in need of a good laugh.
Yeah. I do feel with that one.
Yeah, honey, I want to say focus on you at the moment. Try to keep a good routine. I would even focus just sitting and sit with your feet on the floor, clear your mind, and just focus on your breath work, because what we do when we breathe, like those nice, slow, deep breaths, through it, and so exhale through the nose, hold it for like 4 or 5 seconds if you can, and then breathe out. What you're doing is you're raising your vibrations, which is helping get the oxygen into your body, but it's also helping with your mindset as well with that. Okay, I am working on putting an anxiety short video together at the moment. I'll probably run it as a little free webinar for people just on anxiety and fear. So I'm hoping to have that finished in the next week with that. So keep your eye out on that. Reach out to people, talk to people. You know, technology is an amazing thing. So surround yourself with that positive as much as you possibly can, okay?
And I did have this card was sitting on the top, and it's success. Mm. What my eye went to straight away was actually the affirmation. And it's, I am well looked after. I feel confident about my future. So if you keep that in your head like it's a little mantra, I am well looked after and I'm confident about my future, do focus on that rather than anything that feels like it's pulling you down. Okay? So,
and you can probably even add I am strong in that as well.
Yeah. Yeah. So, excuse me. That felt a bit lit. So we've got Sarah who is saying good morning as well, and may she have a card. Was it yours or mine?
Yours, I think.
There we go. Look at that. We've just passed it. Easter eggs. Chocolate, yum. And this is about what mine was like. Yeah, although there was branding on the ones that I did. I like lint. There was branding on the ones I was So for you, Sarah, what this is, it's the card that heralds a time of positive new beginnings and powerful accomplishments. So the energy around you at this time feels upbeat and optimistic. So as one phase of life passes in order, a new phase is set to begin. So an old aspect of life has to die, a metaphoric death, in order for something new to be born. It's like planting seeds. They have to die to actually create the new growth. So it's a perfect time to start something new. Keep a positive attitude, stay hopeful, because lots of good things are about to happen for you. And your affirmation is, I start each day fresh and new in the knowing that I will always be supported. I remain ever positive, cheerful, and joyous. So there's your card, Sarah. So hopefully that gels with you. And we'll move on to next. There. This is, I was going to say right up your alley, because you do the mediumship so perfectly well. I still feel like I'm learning.
Oh, thank you.
We'll be fine with
Honey, my heart goes out to you. All right. I do feel sadness around you. But I hear I am saying there's questions around the way that Mum passed, because I don't feel that you have all the answers that you are seeking. Okay. I'm very much drawn to the heart, the lungs, the chest area with her. So I do get the feeling her energy is quite weak because she's not long passed. But I do get the reference to that you feel her energy around you. Please trust that, because I get you're not alone. All right. So I just want to say, focus on your grief at the moment. Allow yourself to heal in the way that you need to, because I feel that you're putting a lot of pressure on yourself. Okay. I do feel Mum's energy is quite peaceful. So I do feel that she is resting well. Okay. Mm-hmm. And she's healing. All right. So wishing you all the very best. Send you a big hug.
Thank you. And then straight under almost, we've got Pascal as the 8 responding with the chatbot trigger, which is the 8. If you remember, Leanne said that about that one earlier. So if you want that reminder set, that was, I can't remember what it was. Anyway, what we've got straight under is Mel mentioning that her mother-in-law passed away kind of unexpectedly 2 weeks ago.
There's something with the 2 weeks. What is it with 2 weeks?
That's funny. That's what just picked my, my eye picked that. Like, it, beside the fact it's one or the other, but they're together, like the 2 weeks.
Yeah, and I found out a couple of days ago a friend of ours passed and he wasn't actually found for 2 weeks.
Oh, wow.
So, he passed just in the last couple of weeks.
Yeah. I mean, I'm feeling with Mel's mum-in-law for me, and I'm giving it a go.
Go for it. I love it.
Yeah, for me, what I'm feeling around that is the unexpected bit. I'm just getting that message that, look, there wasn't any pain associated with the passing. I'm feeling it was actually really gentle and at ease. So even though it may have been a suddenly, your mother-in-law personally didn't suffer through that. I'm feeling it probably was something that was either a hefty stroke or a heart attack is the type of thing I'm feeling that she passed with. So if you could affirm that, that's fine. She's in and amongst those who are the loving ancestors, and she is being nurtured. As Leanne said, like as far as the length of time, the strength isn't there yet of what is being sent. It's just the general feeling around what I'm getting. It certainly is the message that, look, there wasn't any pain associated with it, and in the unexpectedly it felt like it was very swift as well and painless. So hopefully that eases your mind, and she is actually in that loving energy of what is the ancestral home, basically. So feel comforted in that, and certainly there is that love around the experience. It just feels very loving. So the 2 weeks was what caught my eye. I thought, wow, interesting.
Yeah,
but we'll do one more because we're just past the 11:30. And we finish off with what you've got in your card set there.
Okay, wonderful. All right, there we go. One's jumped out. Oh, look at the relationship with the close male, honey. I get there's a lot of wisdom around that, and there's growth coming, okay? The 28 comes down to a 10, which is a 1, so I get new beginnings with that. So if you're in a relationship, I feel you're moving into change, which is going to make the relationship stronger. If you're meeting somebody new, I get a very strong relationship there, okay? So it's all about love. It's all about the heart at the moment. Okay.
Wonderful.
So wishing you all the best.
Thank you. Thank you for that. And everybody who's put their comments and questions in here. Because as I'm scrolling down, it looks like there's just as many still to come. Oh, thank you. Oh, my goodness. Well, thank you, Pasquale. That's wonderful to have the feedback. So thank you. Unfortunately, we have actually run out of time for doing the cards and things like that. Well, that's interesting. Thank you, John, for your comment. We all are in a wonderful free country that we can have our own opinions about everything. And we have that without judgment. So thank you. Now, what I'm going to do is I'm going to pop this up because I can, because I'm the host. So because this is sponsored by, you know, the Hypnosis Club, all those sorts of things we're supposed to do marketing-wise, but I never get around to. So I'm going to drop that off. So that is actually my – it's getting very aged now. It's my business card. As I first started doing this psychic medium journey, it's what I create. I still actually like it, so I'm still going to use it. But, you know, just one of those things. And what I'm doing – does that go that way? No, it doesn't. I want to do the big one. So – this one is
put me down into corner, Ros, while you do.
I'm trying to figure. Yeah, I just have to mute the video, isn't it? Yes. Yeah. So I've done that. And then I can actually get that. No, wrong way around. So I can get that and still talk to it. So my course, it's the first one that I have ended up getting it to a nearly finished stage. I mean, the process is there. It will start next Monday. At I think it's either 7 or 8 o'clock Monday night, the 20th. So the way that I've structured it is so you can have the opportunity to pay in full at $100 or $30 each week, but before it goes to being Monday. So I have to actually have that PayPal link, or which I think I've got it just PayPal set up at the moment, but it's to have it paid for before coming into the Zoom meeting room that will be the way that this is presented. So it's just going to be fun. I mean, you've probably got to know me and my energy now and how I deal with things. So it is going to be a fun course. Those are the four topics that will be the basis of each week, so that if you really prefer to just come for the last, I don't mind. It's they may or may not lead from one into the other. That's what you've got to find out at the time. It's preferred that you do all four because they do balance out what is a course. So I thought, well, I will start to promote this, and it'd be lovely if you can promote it as well to people that you think might be interested in I won't say formal course. It's not a certificated, certified or anything like that. It's just a fun course to learn how to do your cards in a lot more relaxed and intuitive style. Okay?
Love it.
How do I hide that? I just go hide. That's a fun question.
Oh, because I love the way you answer your own question.
I do, don't I? That comes from 6 years of living by myself, and the only person I had to entertain myself was me.
Love it. So wonderful.
I just noticed this as the last comment as I'm about to finish off. I like you are putting up subtitles for the hard of hearing. Is that a Facebook thing? Because I haven't done it.
No, I think it's just the comments that we're putting up.
Oh, okay.
That's what I presume that Lynn is meaning by that.
Yeah, because on YouTube, you can actually create the subtitles as you're talking. Facebook. And I thought, I didn't think Facebook do that. Ah, there you go. So thank you for clarifying that. Cool.
Yeah,
thank you for thank you for being part of our show today. To you who are in the audience as live and those who are going to watch the replay, thank you for coming over from the cross-posted pages, if you managed to find the links right. it's been a wonderful session. I just love our shows, and thank you most especially to Leanne for being part of it. So thank you
for having me.
What have you got coming up so that you can let people know?
What have I got coming up? Not so much things in person. I'm working very much on the online workshops at the moment, so my beginners one level is up and running, and I've discounted that by 35%. So if you're interested in learning and how to strengthen your intuition and understand it better, that's certainly is designed around that. I'm now offering at the moment, I used to go out and do private parties in people's homes. I'm offering that as an online thing now. We did one on the weekend and had a bowl. So if you want to get some friends, family together, you can sit in your comfort of your own homes. I send you a link and we set up a time and everybody in that group gets a reading. So, and that is through a Zoom program.
Do you have a limit to the number you have in the room at the one time when you do your group reading?
I would say 10 to 12 at the most. Otherwise, it goes on too long. That's it. And something else that I am looking at doing is actually like when the Fringe was on, I was doing shows twice a week, their live shows. I'm looking at taking that online as well. So what I will do for that is actually only sell a limited amount of tickets. I'm thinking probably 15 tickets to each show. It'll probably be a Sunday evening. I've got to put that together this week. So you purchase your tickets, everybody will get a reading in that group as well. And the same thing, it'll be done online as well. So I might try and hold one of those a week if I can get the numbers. So, and I'll reduce the price. A ticket would normally sell for $55. I'm thinking around the $28, $30 mark per ticket. And then, like I said, everybody gets a rating.
Question with that one too.
Yeah.
With that one where you're having the group that's the 12 or whatever and you everyone gets a reading that has a ticket in that one, so there isn't actually a time limit per se for that session.
But no.
It will go for as long as it needs to for everyone to have their reading.
Yeah, I would say the show will go for around about 2 hours sort of thing. So if, you know, there's only 10 people in that group, it just means people's readings will be longer in that sense, so they'll get more information.
Wow. And they're all recorded, are they?
They are. So recordings will be available. Excellent.
In a group.
Yeah. Not a
private group.
So if you want to get some friends and family together and have your own private group, speak to people, see what dates suit you, and then come back to me with some dates and we can book it in. I send you a payment link, which will also have the link to the show in your payment ticketing side of it, and then we go from there. It's a ball. It really is. You can grab a glass of wine, a coffee, whatever you want, sit and do it as a group.
Sounds exciting. Good stuff.
Yeah, something a bit different.
But what I'm looking at now is seeing as, you know, because we are closing off, and who was that one for? It's Lynn Palmer's. I put this up, right? I like that you're putting the subtitles for the harder hearing, which, and thank you from Joanne, so thank you for the thank you. And Lynn's saying it comes up on the screen. Like my sis is deaf, and this is the one I like too. You're both lovely. You seem absolutely lovely. Thank you.
Thank you for your kind words.
And both of you. So it's not just singling out one or the other. So that's good. I like the balance.
Oh, I like.
Oh, wow, good services, ladies. Yeah, it is. I think there's so much potential in the technology we've got. Look, you're not going to miss out just because there's not going to be the live, in real life factor happening. There's options. There's ways of doing it.
Yeah.
And if I got off my butt, I'd offer that similar. It won't be the same because we're not the same people.
No, we do our own things.
What I like, Pascal is saying everything you guys are saying is coming up on the screen. So maybe there is a new change with Facebook that gives the deaf the opportunity to be a part of it. And I absolutely love that idea. So thank you for letting us know that, Lynn and Pascal.
We might have to go back and watch the replay.
Well, I'm going to for that factor. Is it recorded? I don't know. YouTube it is, unless you turn it off. I don't know the settings. There could have been something new. All these new things, like these widgets. So what's your temperature gone up to?
It's still the same.
Yes. And I am going to leave it there. So thank you very much. Oh, whoops, except I'll take that. No, I'll leave the widgets there. Thank you so much, everyone. Thank you, Leanne, especially. And it'll be lovely to see you all next week about the same time at 10:30, probably a little bit more on time than the nearly late like we were this morning. That was my fault. Anyway,
because I was the one that brought the subject up.
Oh, look, it's great.
Yeah.
And we'll see you then. So share it, you know,
tomorrow night at 8:30 as well.
Yeah, that's right. You have yours on, and that's on the Leanne Winston Psychic Medium page or
My Time TV.
My Time TV. It will be cross-posted too, don't forget.
It will.
Okay. Thank you, everyone, and we'll see you next week. Me tomorrow morning at 8:00.